Taste of Country Nights, Evan and Amber here with Tracy Lawrence. What's happening, man?
What's up, baby?
Good to see you, man. Now, you re-recorded a lot of these songs for the new album after like 25 years, per se. So I want to know, like, from a production standpoint, like, was there anything you recorded originally that after all these years, you were like, man, I wish I had taken a breath at a different time in the song and changed it? Like, was there a click in the background that you heard that you wanted to fix?
I wish I hadn't have done such rangy songs. I had to, some of them are kind of rough, you know,
like after harder 30 to years hit.
A little bit harder to get those really high notes or a challenge sometimes.
Some of these, I mean, these songs are classics. They're staples of the 90s. Was it hard to re-record them and not compare them to the ones that you originally recorded?
In some ways, but I tried to stay right on top of them. I mean, really, this is my road band, and we really tried to you know, just kind of make it like the original records were. We did do some overdubs, some acoustic guitar stuff. There's a lot of acoustic guitar work that just needed some better clarity on. But, I mean, it's production stuff has changed a whole lot. We got Pro Tools now. You can pretty much get on top of anything. I mean, I did an album on Universal where we did some remakes several years ago over in DreamWorks Universal. And I had the engineer take the original record when we were redoing these things and copy it down and put a click track to it. So when it counted off, I had the original record to redo my vocals to, so I could start my notes at the exact same time. I mapped it while I was doing my vocal.
Wow.
Yeah. That's pretty anal, isn't it?
In your career, were you ever strongly encouraged to record a certain song by your record label?
You know, you'd be surprised to know this. When I did a song called Renegades, Rebels, and Rogues on the Maverick soundtrack, and during that, it was I wanted to do it, but I got the label to agree to let me co-produce the record at the time. First time I'd been able to do that, because James Stroud had done all my stuff up to then. And then for the next album, I kind of negotiated the same thing. Rick Blackburn wanted me to do a Bobby Braddock song called Texas Tornado, and I really didn't like it that much. And I said, okay, if you'll let me do a piece of the album and produce it, I said, I'll do your song. So I wound up getting to do Texas Tornado, Any Fool Can See, and a duet called Hillbilly with a Heartache with John Anderson were the three things that I produced on I See It Now. So that's how I got started in producing my records.
Wow.
You came out of that one on top.
Yeah, you did. Yeah.
Was there ever a song that you didn't get to have your hands on, but you heard and you were like, "Dadgummit, I wish that was mine."
Oh, 19 something, Mark Wills. I wish I'd have found it. Yeah. That was a good record. Really good, strong lyric. I think a lot of it.
So did it ever come across your desk, or is it just one that just didn't get to you ever?
Didn't get to me. Nope. Didn't make its way to me. And he had a good record on it. Yeah. there's a few of those out there. Yeah.
Larry the Cable Guy makes an appearance in You Find Out Who Your Friends Are video. Are there any like other odd friendships you've made over the past, like in your career?
You know, I've had access to a lot of people. Troy Aikman and I were real tight for a long time. You know, I've met Brett Favre. I've hung out with Terry Bradshaw, you know, just a handful of actors and people out in LA, some pretty prominent people in the play world in New York. Got to hang out with Carrot Top. My goodness. I mean,
you know, what was that like?
Oh, he's a trip, man. He's a piece of work. But, you know, and a lot of politicians over the years. I've met a lot of folks, not only in Tennessee, but on the national level, a lot of other states. So
that's
I've had a pretty cool life.
Which of your new songs are, like, going over the best at live shows?
You know, I was just looking at the streaming numbers over the weekend. Runaway Heart's been downloaded more off this album than any of the first two packages at this point. I was kind of surprised by that. Price of Fame, something that gets a good reaction. That one's working really well. Water is another one off the first record that's working really well. There's a handful of them. It's really hard to gauge, man. I'm having to look at the analytics from streaming platforms to try to gauge what's working, and I've never had to do that
before. So you do that to base your set list?
It does influence it. But, and you know, I'm starting to see more people singing the words. This album just came out like Friday.
Yeah.
And by yesterday, I was in Virginia last night, I'm already seeing people sing the words back to me. So they're on it already.
That's got to be a good feeling.
Are there any songs that at this point in your career you're kind of like tired of singing?
All of them. You know, there's times that Sticks and Stones gets a little old, but I still love it. You know, that was the first one. I've been doing that song for 30 years.
Wow.
A long time.
That's a
yeah.
Do you ever forget the lyrics, or they're just like tattooed? No,
they're tattooed in there.
We want to play a game with you called the 60 Second Song Challenge.
Okay.
So far, two country artists have played. Amber will pull up their scores there.
Very good.
You have to finish the lyric that we provide to you.
We're going to play about 3 seconds of a song.
Okay.
Okay. It's going to go as quick as you can because you only got.
It's going to go fast.
Okay.
So you got to finish the lyric, and then we'll immediately move on to the next one.
Okay.
If you really get stumped, you can say pass. Pass. Okay. Move on. So our high score is Michael Ray so far.
Really?
He got 10. Okay. Scotty got 9.
Okay.
Scotty McCreary was in. He got 9. So
grab some cans.
Yeah, right, so I got some right over there for you.
Who's doing the timer? Oh, yes,
mine. That's you. You got 66 minutes. Oh, this is, I'm so excited for you.
Okay.
Okay.
Ready, go.
I read what she wrote. Do you love me?
Do you want to be my
We
baby?
Laid rubber on the Georgia asphalt.
We got a little dirty, but we never got caught.
The world is
loving. I don't know the words.
I don't ever want to wake up.
I'm passing.
Just when I think moving on is getting closer,
I'm coming over. Shout,
let on.
Went past.
So come on, baby, come on over.
And I'm a material girl.
I don't know if I'll ever go.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight.
Okay. So you got a car. Okay. So you got a car.
That's it.
You got 6,
there,
buddy.
Go.
Listen, that's
got
not. Listen, you did get the Madonna song.
Hey, nobody gets the Madonna song.
So
we thought you would get Watermelon Sugar High because you're your daughters.
Damn.
I know. I was like, I told Patrick. Listen, Patrick was out to get you all now.
Oh,
I was like,
surprise me.
I know. He was like, maybe put some One Direction on there. He's got.
Didn't know
got
anything about. Did I pass on a One Direction?
No,
but okay. Harry Styles.
Yeah, Harry Styles.
I don't know anything about
it. I don't know.
That. If it had been a Lady Gaga, I'd have probably known it.
You passed on the.
I love Gaga. I mean, that's what I do. I dig Gaga a lot. Not so much. I love Gaga.
You did miss the Travis Denning, so don't tell him.
Okay. Don't tell him.
Tracy Lawrence, man, we appreciate y'all. Appreciate you coming by. Everybody, pick up his album and see him on the road.
Awesome.